The gem cannot be polished without friction, nor man is perfected without trials. This has been the motivation I heartily kept all these years in my life. I am Jean Yanuyan Hamon, 34 years old, a registered nurse and currently working here in Saudi Arabia. The story I will share for now is not the best actually. It is filled with poignant moments, bombarded with trials, but still it's the best because it's real. For me, success is not measured with monetary digits and socio-economic status. Para sa akin, ang success ay matamis after mong malampasan lahat ng pagsubok along your journey. Yung mga pagkakataong mapapamangha ka na lang sa sarili mo habang binabalik-tanaw mo ang mga pangyayari sa buhay mo at kung paano ka nakarating sa estado mo ngayon despite all the obstacles encountered. Ang sarap nun. Growing up with a very strict father, I wasn't able to enjoy my childhood years. I was aloof to the point that taking pictures of me became very terrifying. I used to live a life full of norms and standards set by my family, and the worst were those set by the community. Yun bang dapat ganito ka? Ito yung dapat mong gawin para walang maipintas sa'yo ang ibang tao. Bakit di mo tularan si ganito? Dapat maging isang abogada, doktora, guro, nurse, at iba pa kagaya ni ganito. Babae ka, so act like one. These were only some of those lines na nagmarka pa rin sa aking isipan until now. Nakakainis pero somehow it's challenging. I've maintained my rank in school consistently. Graduated valedictorian in elementary and salutatorian in high school and got scholarships for my college. Yes. Opportunities opened up for me in some colleges and universities. Unfortunately, all those just slipped off of me. I enrolled civil engineering in a university in Cagayan de Oro as a scholar. Everything was just fine for a couple of weeks, hanggang sa bigla ko nilang naramdaman ang matinding kalungkutan, yung sobra talaga. Siguro dahil it was my first time na mahiwalay sa parents ko at medyo malayo pa. I decided to withdraw my enrollment, went home to Camiguin, and transferred with another course, commerce major in banking and finance. Everything went smoothly. My grades were great with all those praises from our professors, and I even excel in some competitions. Kasabay nitong lahat ay ang mga bagay na di ko naisip na mangyayari pala sa akin. Natuto akong magwarkada, uminom, cutting classes, at pumasok ng nakainom. Kasama na dito ang ilang beses na mga pagsisinungaling. Nakailang daan na rin ako sa bintana ng aming boarding house. Oo, ganun kalala. Literal na malala. And then love comes my way. I was deeply, madly in love with one of my closest friends since high school. Masaya syempre, unang pag-ibig ba naman. Our story was just atypical at first. Yung kailangan mo nang itago dahil sa takot na baka patigilin sa pag-aaral and of course, baka mapag-usapan ng karamihan. Hanggang sa nagtagal, turned into a deep, strong against all odds relationship. Surpassed so many trials, but along the way, mistakes and sacrifices were part of it. Kasama na dito yung ilang beses na pagkatigil ng aking pag-aaral, mga paglalayas, premarital intimacies. There were too many second chances wasted. A lot of down moments, being judged, halos itinakwil na ng pamilya. Oo, talagang lugmok ako, laman ng halos lahat ng usap-usapan. I even came to the point of ending my life. Salamat na lang sa napakabusilak na puso ng aking ina. She's the only one who kept on forgiving me over and over. Hanggang finally, I got my last chance to continue my studies with the course I wanted. Bachelor of Arts in Nursing. I tried fixing my life and did well in my studies again along with my efforts to rebuild everybody's trust in me. Tinuloy ko lang ang laban, and in God's divine will, I graduated. Took the board exam and passed it. Salamat sa Diyos talaga. Sa kabila ng mga kamalian ko, di niya ako pinabayaan. Wala na akong sinayang na panahon. Agad akong nagtrabaho as paid volunteer in a district hospital. At unti-unti nang nakakatulong sa aming pamilya kahit papano. Ito naman ang isa sa mga goals ko. An opportunity knock again, and this time, medyo kailangan ng isang mahirap na desisyon. Masakit at mahirap malayo sa aking pamilya, but this time, I took the risk. Pursued going abroad in Saudi Arabia as a private duty nurse last September 2015. From then, up to this time, I continued working here, and sa awa ng Diyos, mas malaki-laki na ang napoprovide ko para sa aking pamilya. I am not saying na yumaman na ako, subalit, I will be forever grateful because we have enough. Di maikakaila that my story was not the best. It was just a mere story of a woman scarred by all her imperfections, pained by all the heartaches and betrayals. Oo, mayroong regrets, syempre. If I could just turn back time, I'd rather be just in my previous cage, aloof, living with those standards, if only in this way I got to embrace those opportunities. Kaso wala, nangyari na ang lahat. What's making it the best are those chances I embraced despite everything. All the apologies that have been forgiven, the risks I took, and the obstacles I surpassed. Successful kong maituturing ang sarili ko kahit hindi ako mayaman. Wala akong master's degree na may pagmamalaki, and I'm not working in a dollar or euro earning countries. Subalit, the fact that I can now call myself as a provider in our family and able to extend my support to my nieces and nephews, the best I'm feeling. As of now, success for me is seeing my parents happy, having the chance to support my nieces and nephews until the time they graduate, and witnessing them reaching their dreams as I continue reaching mine. As of now, they're my treasure, my inspiration. They're that missing pieces to complete the meaningful puzzle of my life. Yes, I don't have the wealth and fame, but I am contented, blessed, and forever grateful. That scarred young girl in the past is now fixed, strong, independent, and driven woman, ready to face challenges in order to be a precious and brilliant gem that my family hoped me to be. As of now, I am a faithful believer to Allah. To God be the glory. Aloha Akbar.